Good morning students, welcome to online session of social sciences. In previous class we have studied that physical environment is broadly divided into four domains. First, lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere and biosphere. In that class we have studied two kinds of spheres, that is lithosphere and atmosphere. In today's class we are going to understand the hydrosphere. The term hydrosphere stands for water, means this hydrosphere, that is a combination of two words. First, hydro, it means water, and sphere means area. That means area which is containing water is called hydrosphere. The water present on the earth's surface is referred to as hydrosphere. The water supports all forms of life, means plants are there, animals and human. This water supports the every form of life. It is found in three states. First is solid as ice, second liquid as water, third gaseous in a manner of vapor or moisture. The sphere of water, that is oceans, seas and lakes etc., covers 71% of earth's surface, means suppose that total earth surface is 100%. Out of this 100%, 70% of the earth surface is covered with water. Now, a small quantity of water is held by the atmosphere and also goes around the underground on the continents during precipitation. Now, that 71% water, that is on the earth surface. Beside this water, we are having small quantity of water that is always present in our atmosphere, and some amount of that water that is going underground on the continent during precipitation. Precipitation can be in any manner. It can be a snowfall or rainfall. This water is also a part of hydrosphere. Now, whenever we will speak hydrosphere, means three things should be there. First, that 71% of the that 71% water that is on earth's surface. Then second, the small quantity of water that is held by the atmosphere. Third, that water that goes underground on the continents. All together they are making hydrosphere. The oceans are teeming with life. Teeming with means a very large group. So our oceans, they are having a large group of life there, means living organisms there. Even at depths where sunlight cannot penetrate means reach, means even in the very deep depth where that sunlight is not reaching, still there we are having living organisms there. This oceanic life is of fundamental importance to life found on earth. Fundamental importance means basic importance, means whichever that life is found, we are finding on earth, like we animals all are having a very much dependent, you can say, on the oceanic life. The water in ocean is ultimately precipitated on land through the hydrological cycle, means but it is saying the water in ocean is ultimately precipitated on land, means when you will see water cycle, that many processes are there. First process is what? That water is getting evaporated. Then it is reaching to cloud. There it is condensing. Condensation process is there. After condensation, that precipitation is there. Precipitation means rainfall or snowfall. So ultimately means at the end of that process, what will happen? That water which has been evaporated from the ocean, now it reach to land. Life on land depends on this water. Now the living organisms that are on the land, they are totally dependent on this water, means without water life is not possible. Ocean perform the following useful function. Now few functions are there which are performed by oceans. First is provide a link to land masses or continents. Now what this water, that hydrosphere, is doing, it is providing link. Link means connection between. landmasses. Landmasses mean their land is there. As we are having seven continents, and along with seven continents, we are having oceans. Then what this water is doing, what this ocean is doing, it is providing connection from one continent to another continent. Second, much of the water that falls as rain, snow, etc. on the land comes from the ocean. Now from where this water is coming? All this water that is coming from the ocean itself. From ocean, it is getting evaporated, reaching to cloud. There it is condensation is there. After condensation, it is coming again down to earth or land in the manner of precipitation. And that precipitation, it can be rain or snow, etc. All water flowing in streams, river, or that which is stored in lakes or underground is made available by precipitation. Now, wherever you are finding water, whether you are finding water in rivers, where you are finding it in streams, or you are getting in lakes or underground water, all this water are available with the help of precipitation process. Third is, ocean provides us food, minerals, mineral oil, gas, and are used for navigation. Now what this ocean is doing, it is providing us food. Which kind of food? That fish we are getting, or seafoods we are getting, then many precious minerals we can get from the ocean, mineral oils and gases we can have, and other used for navigation. Navigation means to a movement of ship, means from one place to another place that ship can easily move. This much for today's class. Next, we will meet in the next class with the topic of biosphere.